It's very possible. It's possible.
It's just like we can't use that much of our brains, you know, in a way. I think even if we could stimulate all that in our brains, you know, maybe so, you know.
You got to turn on a higher percentage of your brain function. You're good at that. You have to turn on, yeah, a lot of your brain function, but it is possible. You know? Yeah, it just is the same thing as that happened in the spirit world, like we've talked about in other videos, where things happen instantly and it just is real, this world. It's like that. It's this universe, too, if you want it to be, if you know it to be with absolute knowledge.
Yeah, think of yourself being in a ship and saying, you know, telling left, right, forward with your mind. You know?
Or this planet and that planet.
They're starting, you know,
call that up in your mind. They're starting
to
move there.
Yeah, they're starting to try to make things on this planet, you know, that are like that. But the technology is way off, you know, of course. But I wanted to mention on that because I've seen a few things that they're trying to invent that you use your mind to control it and everything. But to us, it's almost like that's futuristic, you know.
Yeah, well, it's not. Thought is everything. Millions of years ago, this is going on. Show billions. They a lot of races of species of beings in the universe are already figured out. Thought is everything. Hundreds of billions of years ago.
Yeah.
You know, and we're sitting here still primitive.
What can I say? Like, man made, you know, man or thought created machines. Now they have the machines trying to create the matter of thought.
Yeah.
But it's a way, it should be backwards, or totally backwards, or in a different order. Because really our minds are the most important thing that we have, you know, that has created everything that we've got, of course, you know, the thought.
I'm seeing this, like there's some race of beings, like, that don't even need ships. Like, all they do is disassemble their bodies and move through space and time and reassemble physical bodies where they want.
Yeah, see, now, you know? That's something I have seen. Can I touch on that?
Yeah, I've seen that.
One time I was sitting in my living room and something appeared to me like that, you know, it just appeared like a human body, you know, it was a complete human form. Like, when I say that, you know, it wasn't like something you put your hand through or anything like that. It was like, you know, it was physical like this.
It wasn't like the way we see spirits. This woman could have walked in here, walked in the door, like a person.
She put her hands over my head and everything in my neck. I felt like she could take my life, you know, or just do anything she wanted to. But she didn't, or, you know what I'm saying? But the reason I wanted to bring that up because things can do that, apparently. They can form and unform, you know, like...
travel.
Yeah, and apparently, all those things.
We can do that, too. That's another thing we're capable of that we've forgotten as beings. We can do that, too.
That would be an interesting thing to be able to do.
You can be anywhere in the universe just by thinking about it. That's how they work. You know? Mm-hmm. They can be in the spirit world, too. They can pick up a body, drop it. Physical body, take one on, drop it, go to another dimension, pick up another one. You know, that's one of the most advanced.
I think they even use our astral body sometimes. You know, I wanted to touch on that. Maybe we can even go further into astral projection another time. But they definitely, you know, you can use our astral bodies just as good as they can use our physical bodies. So you have to wonder what's up with that.
Now, those are what people might call gods. That's gods, right? Those are gods, too. Everyone's a god, but they're really practicing it. You know, they know they have no limits.
Absolutely.
You know, nothing's limiting them. Nothing's off limits. You know, they can do anything and nothing to fear. You know?
That's right.
That's the way it's important that we live in this world. You got to live like that. You know, no fear about anything.
Yeah, you have to exactly. It's something to practice, no fear, you know.
Fearlessness is...
is also king.
Is king. Because true fearlessness, you know, turns your thought patterns into absolute knowledge after a while. To where, like, you know, you don't even question, there's no question about if something's going to happen or not. And you think, you just know it will. You know, like, you just automatically know it will, and you just do it. But it's like, let me put a good example, like, is the video of Jeremy and me, it's popping out our other bodies, the astral bodies, while we sit here to work in other dimensions at the same time we talk to y'all.
Exactly.
You know, we can now be operating in different places at the same time. Like, we do that because there's no doubt. There is no doubt. I just do it. I just know it's done. That's all you have to do is know it's done, and it just happens. Like, we get there, and the portal opens up. I just know it's opening. I command it to open just by knowing it.
And he sees it
at the exact same time. I'm like, we tested it. I sat there silently, and I told him to speak up when the portal blew up.
Well, when it shut.
Or when it shuts.
Yeah. And we get it accurately every time. I mean, there's no prompting on any of this. We just know, like, we've studied.
You see the same thing.
Astral projection is something that I've been very into.
I wouldn't call it astral projection because we're forming spirit bodies. You know, we're not connected to these bodies. Those bodies operate on their own. You know, like, we actually have another us working independently. Astral bodies are connected by a cord to your physical bodies a lot of the time. You know, energy link. What some people have seen, that silver cord, people call it that. But it's actually light. It's like a waving rope of light.
I don't think astral projection is a word.
It's not a good way to describe it.
Yeah, it's leaving your
face. Astral projection is better, describe dream.
Yeah,
and
exactly.
Out-of-body experiences.
Right, no, because, I mean, I've sat out in the grass. I've been in my bed and sat out in the grass, you know, and sat there and been as small as rocks, you know, and things like that. You know, it's much different than going and, you know, leaving your body or making your body a different form and going to the portal.
But we didn't have to mess this body up at all. We didn't have to, you know, send a portion of us out. We just formed another body, you know, to be there.
It's kind of hard to explain. But
basically, we just knew it could happen.
Yeah,
you know, when you know it can happen, there's no limit
to
your power. You know, that's a good word. It is power, you know, a form of power.
It's a form of power.
You know, let's write that down. You know, knowing you have no limits.
Well,
form of power. See, we learn things as we're learning too. As we talk, we're learning.
We learn a lot from each other. We learn a lot from doing these videos, and we learn a lot from you guys. So we hope that you definitely will send questions and answers.
We got a lot more to touch on.
Yeah.
You know,
we got more. Well, a whole lot more to touch on.
And I think we might continue on this thing. Like, next video we do, we've got a couple of minutes left on this one. But we come up on that Facebook 20-minute limit, so we try to make each one about 20, you know. But I'm thinking, we ought to talk about, you know, absolute knowledge some or something like that. We can continue. Well, let's just pick up another video after this, you know.
We definitely will.
And we'll continue talking about this. Like, that's the best way you can put it. Like, it just forms. Like I said, like, we're in the spirit world and we're here.
Yeah.
You know, completely separate, but yet it's connected. It doesn't look connected physically, but it's connected spiritually.
I mean,
and connected through space-time and dimensional connections.
It's hard to say. You're just here and then you're there. You know, it's, like, kind of hard to explain.
You're there at the same time. You know, it's right.
Well,
I can't explain it more.
We hope that maybe these videos and our words and vibes and things will help you get to that point where you can do it too, because it's possible for everyone to
do that. That's what we're teaching here, is that you can do this too. That's what we're trying to say.
Well,
but let's finish this up because we're almost at 20.
All right.
And we're going to pick back up in a few minutes.
All right. Thank you.
All right. Peace.